Good morning, everybody. Pastor Stitch, Narrow Path Christian Church, BC, Bay City, Michigan. Welcome to the Biker Devotional. So, some of you have been waiting a little while because I'm on late. Didn't have to work. Worked myself out of work yesterday at work and had the opportunity to sleep in. That was good. But I also took the time this morning to spend time, extra time, in prayer and communion with God. And it got me thinking about something, and that is the amount of time that we actually take in prayer, literally talking about time, not the number of times you pray, God help me in this moment, or I don't want this, or Lord be with those people, or whatever, but literally taking time to pray. Going into it with just a decision that I'm going to pray and let your thoughts go towards what it is that God would have you pray about. Whether it be stuff in your life, stuff in other people's lives, stuff in the life of the church in general, your congregation, whatever it might be. How often do we do that? Some of you may have been sitting by your phone, scrolling your feed, waiting for me to pop up. How much time did you do doing that in comparison to how much time have you spent praying? It's a good question, and I'm not condemning you, because the literal answer to this is you can talk to 98% of the pastors in the world, and if they're being honest with you, they'll admit they don't pray enough. I am one of those. I know I need to pray much more. But I can also tell you that things changed in my life on a day very specific to prayer. Someone challenged me with the words that Jesus used towards his disciples in the garden. You know, and Jesus had that last meal with them. They'd gone out. They were singing praises. They went to the garden. Some of them stayed back in one place. Three of them followed Jesus a little bit further. He said, you guys stay here. I'm going to go a little bit further and I'm going to pray. And incredible prayers that he prayed, by the way. And he went away, and it was, according to Luke, a thing that he had done regularly. John also related the fact that it was very common for him to go and do this thing, to sit down and pray. But he told the three, he said, I need you to watch and pray as I go off and do what I need to do. And he prayed very strenuously and cried out to God about what was coming. And it's not as much about the prayer as the fact that when he came back, he found the three sleeping. And he said to Peter, so couldn't you stay awake with me 1 hour? Stay awake and pray so that you won't enter into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. And the reality is, I got challenged in that. I had been to a prayer meeting where we were gathered together. We were given direction on what to pray for. We all gathered up in the sanctuary, and most of us prayed earnestly for 10-15 minutes, and then what now? I prayed for everything I was supposed to pray for, so we left the sanctuary, we went into the other room, and we were in there talking. And by the end of the hour, the person that had called the prayer meeting came out and said, all right guys, the hour's over, come on in, let's talk about what we prayed about. And he looked at each one of us and he said, I'm so disappointed. Every one of you are here because you said you knew that this was a critical thing to pray about. And we committed to pray for an hour. And you couldn't even pray for an hour. And it pricked me right to my spirit. And for 2 years, every Monday thereafter, I met in that sanctuary, and I prayed for an hour straight. And I'll tell you, it wasn't easy. But learning how to pray for an hour by myself, spending time with the Lord, while there were other people there sometimes it was just me, I learned what it meant to pray. Nothing will change in your life until you change. Now, I will tell you, there are going to be times where you go into this decision to pray for a period of time. An hour is a good amount of time, by the way. And if you say you don't have enough time for it, I'm betting you can pull an hour out of your day if you just try. An hour out of your week if you just try. There are going to come times where you're going to find yourself drowsy. But if you go into that sleep in those times, talking to God, I promise you, He will talk to you in those moments of drowsiness. Don't feel guilty about falling asleep if you're actually doing the work of prayer. I'm betting since Jesus came back three times and found them asleep each time, I'm betting that they didn't actually spend their entire time in prayer. They probably said, Lord, protect Jesus. And I'm tired. I had a good meal. My belly's full. Let me sleep. So my challenge to you today, and I know this has nothing to do with riding a motorcycle other than I can tell you my best prayer hours are spent in the saddle. But the reality is, if you're not committed to prayer, you're not really committed to change. And I know that's going to tick a lot of people off, but it's the truth. You can't see change in your life and you can't see change in the community around you unless you're willing to commit to take it to God and to be in front of them and persevere in it on a regular basis. And that's a fact. Charles Spurgeon called the prayer room at the church the furnace room. Nothing keeps the church heated and moving forward like prayer. And that's a fact. I think we need to revive the furnace room in most churches, including Narrow Path. I love y'all. I hope you have a great day. By the way, don't forget, it is the 26th. You should have read Proverbs 26 today. God bless.